there are certain situations when the space is not maintained. Maybe the patient is not able to visit the dentist immediately after extraction. Maybe the patient was not sensitized about maintenance of space at that time. So there can be such situations. In this case, such clinical finding is there. The teeth start moving, tilting towards each other. So the space loss is evident on both the sides. Here also, we get to see the tilting of the teeth, making the loss of space very. The appliances that we use to regain the space, they are known as space regainers. If you remember, the types of space maintainers, active space maintainer and passive space maintainer. A passive space maintainer is the one which does not apply any force on the teeth, while the active space maintainer is the one which applies force on the teeth and causes tooth movement. So these space regainers are nothing but active space maintainers. These space regainers can be removable or fixed. They can be unilateral or bilateral. They are indicated when we have to re-establish or we have to regain the space up to 3 millimeters. Now it is always good to remember that it's easier for us to regain the space in maxilla because of the presence of cancerous bone in maxilla. While in mandible it is not impossible but little difficult for us. So means maintaining space in time for both the dentitions is very helpful for the child as well as for the dentist. There are certain examples of removable or fixed space maintenance in the form of polished appliances or headgears and fixed in the form of Gerber space maintenance or Jackscrew space maintenance, space regainers. We'll just go through the actual clinical photographs of these situations. So Gerber space regainer. Whenever we have lost, this is a very popular space regainer, a very dentist friendly or user friendly and an effective space regainer. It consists of many of these space regainers, they consist the coil springs. What do we mean by use of coil springs? If you have ever seen, ever used a spring, if you compress that spring and place it somewhere, it tries to get back to its original position. So it tries to expand. If you have compressed and placed it, it tries to expand. Same principle is used while regaining the space. That the coil spring is compressed and placed between the two teeth so that now the spring tries to get back to its original form and position. This leads to separation of the teeth apart from each other, and that's how we gain space. The simple mechanics is used by applying small instruments or small procedures in the oral cavity. So here a band is placed along with the molar tubes and a coil spring is placed into the wire and the U-shaped wire, and that U-shaped wire is inserted into the bands. This is a very simple mechanics but works wonderfully. So here is an example of the Gerber space maintenance. Another simple mechanism for regaining space is a modification of lingual arch where loops, U-shaped loops are given just means here to the lingual arch, and while placement of the lingual arch, the loops are activated. The loops are activated and then the lingual arch is cemented. So this leads to distal movement of the molars or the anterior movement of the incisors. There is Jackscrew type of a space regainer where the two adjacent teeth are banded and they have in between there is a placement of a threaded shaft with screw and a lock nut. So it's something that helps to regain the space faster as compared to any other method. Another method of using coil springs is given in these photos. mandible and maxilla or mandible to regain the space to separate the teeth away from each other. But simultaneously, a non-folding arch, modification of non-folding arch or a lingual arch is used to get an anchorage so that no other tooth moves in undesired direction. Another use of coil spring is the use of the coil spring into a looped wire to separate these teeth from each other. It is known as a looped coil space regainer. A very simple appliance that can be used for used as a space regainer is a lip bumper. So children who have a lip sucking habit, they are best candidates for such an appliance. And children in whom the space loss due to major migration of molars has taken place. So the lip sucking or the pressure on the lip bumper helps the distal movement of these permanent molars. Simultaneously, although when it alters the equilibrium of the forces against the incisors, and there are chances that the incisors might flare labia. So this is a disadvantage of lip bumper. And there is a modification of a distal shoe space maintainer known as sliding distal shoe space maintainer. So this is a light coil spring which is placed along with the distal shoe space maintainer, and that helps moving the molar distal. Another example is known as elastic Hatterman appliance. This is given in our textbooks. It is used in case of space loss or in case of the tooth which is ectopically erupting, major erupting, maybe under the or maybe pushing the second primary molar. So in this case, a mushroom shaped button is bonded or placed on the occipital surface of first permanent molar, and a band is placed on second primary molar, a hook is soldered to it this way, and this hook is activated while placing it onto the tooth. An elastic chain, or a chain elastic, more often it is called an elastic chain. Elastic chain is used in between the this button and the hook so that the hook pulls the first permanent molar distally. Another modification of or some appliance which is similar to the Hatterman's appliance is ectopic spring distalizer, where a band is placed on the second primary molar and a spring is used, and the spring helps push the molar distal. Pushes the molar distal. And another option is lower lingual welding arch with the loops, as we have discussed earlier. There are certain removable space maintainers that are commonly used. One is a slingshot type of removable space regainer. Now remember that as we talked about the space maintainers, same way, removable space regainers to be used in children, although it is difficult, but there are examples of these space regainers. So these are certain examples of space regainers which might prove to be effective. So a slingshot type of a space regainer which uses which uses the simple mechanics of the buckle as well as lingual placements of hooves which help the tooth move distally. And as it resembles the slingshot, the reason why it is called as the slingshot type of appliance. Another very simple example of space regainer is with the help of an expansion screw. An expansion screw is placed such a way that it divides the removable plate into two parts. One part which involves only the tooth to be distalized, and the other part which involves all other teeth. And this expansion screw is activated once a week as we do in as we carry out in arch expansion, bilateral arch expansion. Only thing is that here the sole force is concentrated on the molar that we want to distalize. And the last appliance that can be used for maintain for regaining the space is a removable appliance appliance with a finger spring. So finger spring can be used by incorporating it into a removable appliance. And these appliances